Pleasant morning, dear children. Are you all there? So today we are going to proceed to the next session. I hope all of you are ready there. Shall we start? So last day we were discussing this portion, how an acid, otherwise a base, a concentrated acid, otherwise a concentrated base, how it's being diluted. And we learned the type of reaction that take place when an acid is mixed with water. I hope you remember, such a reaction is an exothermic reaction, a reaction in which a huge amount of heat energy is released. So we discussed the procedure to be followed for diluting an acid, otherwise a base. What's the procedure? Acid to water or water to acid? So definitely acid to water. If you go the other way, that is if you're going to add water to acid, because the reaction is highly exothermic, the reaction mixture may spurt out. So what's the procedure of diluting an acid? In practice session, my dear children, in practice session will be starting at 11:30. So by 11:25, you have to turn your video as well as audio on. No one should be hiding. Today, in practice session, the questions will be point to different persons. So be ready, and those are not turning your video on, you will be getting punishment. Clear? So during dilution, we mix acid, otherwise base, to water. We stir so that we get an acid or base of a required concentration. I'll read this paragraph. Can you all concentrate in your textbook? The process of dissolving an acid or a base in water is a highly exothermic one. That is, it's a highly exothermic reaction. Care must be taken while mixing concentrated nitric acid or sulfuric acid with water. You know, nitric acid and sulfuric acid are corrosive acids. So we have to be extremely careful. And what's the procedure for dilution? We discussed all this. It's just reading. Acid must always be added how? Slowly to water with constant stirring. So the process of dilution of acid is like what? Acid should be slowly added to water with constant stirring. If water is added to concentrated acid, that is if you go the other way, the heat generated may cause the mixture to splash out and it will cause burns. And there is another risk, the glass container also may break due to excessive local heating because it's a highly exothermic reaction. So look out for the warning sign. You can see the warning sign shown in figure 2.5 on the can of concentrated sulfuric acid and on the bottle of sodium hydroxide pellets. You know, sodium hydroxide is also a strong base. Concentrated sulfuric acid is strong and also it is highly corrosive. So the procedure to be followed for diluting acid and base is what? You have to slowly add acid or base to water and keep on stirring till you get a solution of required concentration. Last day we discussed the two terms, concentrating or diluting. You have a solution with you. Suppose it's an acidic solution. Suppose you see that it has to be diluted. What do you usually do? You add more of solvent to it. Which solvent is usually used? Water. So suppose you have dilute HCl, you see that it has to be diluted. What's the procedure? You add more of water. So adding more of solvent helps in diluting a solution. But suppose you want to concentrate it, what should you do? You have to add more of what? Solute. So to make hydrochloric acid, right now you are having, you want to make it more concentrated, what should you do? Add more of water or add more of concentrated HCl to it? Definitely you have to add more of concentrated HCl to it. So the procedure for diluting is what? Add more of solvent. The procedure for concentrating is what? Add more of solute. Please wait. Now we learn the definition for what is concentrating, otherwise what is diluting. I remember asking you to underline the definition. the last paragraph of the page, you have the definition for what is diluting, otherwise what is concentrating. Can you underline this particular sentence? When you mix an acid or a base with water, what will actually happen? Suppose you are mixing an acid with water, what will happen? There will be a decrease in the concentration of H plus ions per unit volume. Otherwise, if you are mixing a base with water, what will happen? There will be a decrease in the concentration of which ion? Base has which ions in it? OH minus ions per unit volume. What do you mean by the term per unit volume? For understanding this concept, we'll discuss an example. You are dissolving 10 gram of sodium chloride in 1 liter of water. You know sodium chloride is common salt. You are taking 10 grams of it and you are dissolving it in 1 liter of water. We'll go for another case. We'll take the same quantity of the solute, that is 10 gram sodium chloride itself, but here we are going to dissolve it in 2 liter of water. Something you all know from your daily life experience, which solution will taste more of salty? Is the first solution or second solution? Definitely it will be the first solution. The second solution will be less salty to taste. But check the constitution of two solutions. Both have the same quantity of solute in it. That is, both solutions have 10 gram of sodium chloride. But in the first one, we have dissolved the 10 gram of sodium chloride in what quantity of water? 1 liter of water. Now what did you do? When you added 1 extra liter of water, it became the second solution. The solute, the quantity is still the same, right? It's 10 gram. But we say the solution has now become diluted. Why? Why we say that it's diluted? Here, in 1 liter of water, NaCl splits to Na plus ion and Cl minus ion. So the ions will be all round distributed in the solution. Here also, this NaCl will split into Na plus and Cl minus ion. The ions get distributed in the solution. In which solutions you'll be able to find more of Na plus and Cl minus if you take up unit volume of a liquid? Which solution will have more of Na plus ions and Cl minus ion? Definitely the first solution, right? The second solution, the same number of Na plus and Cl minus ions are there, but they are distributed far wide. Why? The amount of solute, though it's the same, the amount of solvent is more, right? The first case it was 1 liter of water. In the second case it's double the quantity, 2 liter of water. So though sodium chloride and chloride ions are there in the same quantity, now it's distributed far and wide. So that makes it less concentrated. That is second solution. We say it's less concentrated. Otherwise it is more diluted compared to the first one. So when you diluted this first solution, how did you dilute it? By adding 1 extra liter of water. What actually happened? There was a decrease in the concentration of Na plus ions and Cl minus ions per unit volume, right? Now we'll discuss this with context of our acids. Suppose you take HCl. of HCl. Dissolve it in 1 liter of water. Second case, we take the same quantity of HCl, but now you are going to dissolve it in 2 liters of water. The quantity of solute is the same, that is, it is 5 ml in both the cases, but the quantity of solvent is different. In the first case, it is less of solvent. Second case, it is more of solvent, almost double the quantity of solvent that we have taken in the first case. So which solution will be more concentrated? Which one will be dilute? So this will be the concentrated one, and this we say is relatively dilute compared to the first one. Why? Though the amount of solute is the same, I think you got the concept. In the case of first solution, that 5 ml of HCl is distributed in 1 liter of water. So it has H plus ions, And those H plus ion are distributed only in a small quantity, that is 1 liter of water. So it will be more, it will be more widely, that is compared to the other one, it will be very near to each other, H plus ion. What about the second case? There also you take the same quantity of HCl. That HCl also ionizes to H plus and Cl minus ion. But we say it is dilute. Why? The H plus ions are now far widely distributed. If you take 1 ml of water, that is the solution, and check, there will be less number of H plus ion compared to the first one. So generally we can say, if you want to dilute a solution, you have to add more of what to it? Solvent to it. If you want to concentrate that particular solution, you have to add more of solute to it. So when you want to dilute this hydrochloric acid, what did you do? You added extra solvent. Suppose the same solution, this particular solution, you want to concentrate it, what should you do? You have to add more of what? Solute, that is hydrochloric acid should be added, then only the solution will become more concentrated. I think the concept is clear. So how will you dilute an acid? An acid can be diluted by adding more of water to it. How can you dilute a base? A base can also be diluted by the same procedure, by adding more of the solvent, that is water, to it. How can you concentrate acids? Otherwise, how can you concentrate bases? It can be done by adding, if you are planning to concentrate an acid, what should you do? Add more of concentrated acid to the particular solution. Otherwise, if you want to concentrate sodium hydroxide solution that you are already having, what should you do? Add more of water or add more of sodium hydroxide pellets. What should you do? You have to add more of sodium hydroxide pellets. So that explains what is dilution, otherwise what is concentrating. Now we'll move on to the exercise question. See, when the chapter is over, I'll be sending a PDF format of all these questions and answers. So that time you can copy it in your notebook. Right, for the time being, you just be attentive and listen to the questions and answers. I think we had discussed the first three questions. Now we have to discuss the fourth, fifth and sixth. Be attentive, because I'll be asking all these questions during in practice session. Right, so we'll first discuss the fourth one. So, page number 25, question number 4. While diluting an acid, let it be any acid, why is it recommended that acid should be added to water and not water to acid? What's the reason? Answer is here. If water is added to a concentrated acid, this is the answer. If water is added to concentrated acid, the heat generated may cause the mixture to splash out and cause burns. The glass container may also break due to excessive local heating. So that is why it's never advisable adding water to concentrated acid. So how should the dilution be done? By adding concentrated acid to water. Now back to the next one. Question number 5. How is concentration of hydronium ions affected when a solution of acid is diluted? So a particular solution of acid that you have, it's a dilute acid. What will happen to the amount of hydronium ions when you dilute an acid? So what's the answer? What will happen when you dilute an acid? The answer is here. Mixing an acid with water result in what? Decrease in the concentration of H3O plus ions per unit volume. So when you are diluting acid, the amount of H3O plus ions per unit volume will decrease. Suppose the same question is asked in a different way. How is the concentration of hydronium ions affected when a solution of acid is concentrated? What will be the answer? The concentration of hydronium ions per unit volume will increase. So I think the concept is clear to you. When an acid is diluted, the concentration of hydronium ions decreases. You have to add this per unit volume. Actually, the ions are not going anywhere else when it's being diluted. It's still there, but its relative concentration decreases. Hope the answer is clear. Moving on to question number 6. How is the concentration of hydroxide ions affected when excess base is dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide? So you have a solution of sodium hydroxide. To that you are adding excess of sodium hydroxide solution. What will happen? So what will happen to the concentration of hydroxide ions if excess base means you are adding excess of solute? What will happen to the concentration of OH minus ion? Will it increase or decrease? You're not adding water here, you're adding more of base. So what will happen to hydroxide ion concentration? Definitely it will increase, right? So I'll discuss the answer of question number 5 and 6 one more time. How is the concentration of H plus ion, otherwise H3O plus ion, affected when a solution of acid is diluted? So when an acid or base is diluted, its ions increase per unit volume. In sixth question, what is the case? You're adding more of solute. Here, it's a case of sodium hydroxide to which we are adding excess of base. That is sodium hydroxide, we are adding again. We're adding more of sodium hydroxide to that particular solution. How will the concentration of hydroxide ion get affected? Will it increase or decrease? Definitely, it will increase. So to generalize, to a particular solution that you are having right now, if you're adding more of solvent, we say the solution is now diluted. If you add more of solute, then what do we say? The solution is now being concentrated. To a particular acidic solution, if you add more of water, the amount of H plus ions per unit volume will decrease. If you add more of acid to the solution, the amount of H plus ions per unit volume will increase. The same thing happens with bases. A base is being diluted means OH minus ion concentration per unit volume decreases. If you add more of base to that basic solution, the amount of OH minus ions per unit volume will increase. So we discussed two terms, what is concentrating, what is diluting. So diluting is done with adding more of solvent, and concentrating is done by adding more of solute. I think the portion is clear. We'll move on to the next heading. Next is something that you are learning in your practical manual, laboratory manual. It's actually an experiment. This is the first experiment from chemistry included in your laboratory manual. The topic that you have in your laboratory manual is this. pH. You know, H is hydrogen ion carrying a unipositive charge. Otherwise, it can be represented like what? H3O. Both are same. H plus ion dissolved in water is H3O plus, hydronium ion. We'll go for the heading first. How strong are acid or base solutions? In the introductory part, we have learned how to identify an acidic or basic solution without tasting it. How? With the help of indicators. You have hydrochloric acid. You have acetic acid. Last day, I mentioned a few characteristics of these two acids. We discussed these terms, what's a strong acid, what is a weak acid. I think you remember hydrochloric acid is considered to be a strong acid. Why? It's an acid which ionizes completely. Hydrochloric acid ionizes and form what? H plus ion and Cl minus ion. It ionizes completely and so will produce lot of H plus ions when dissolved in water. What about the next acid, CH3COOH? It's acetic acid. It's a weak acid. It's actually an organic acid and it's considered to be weak. For what reason? We discussed it last day. These acids will not ionize completely. They go for only a partial ionization. A few molecules remain in the combined form itself. They will not be going for ionization. So the first acid is a strong acid. I'm just writing the short form. Second acid is a weak acid. If you did a blue litmus strip in both these acids, the observation will be the same, right? Both these acids will turn the color of blue litmus into red color. So, whether the acid is strong or whether the acid is weak, we can't identify with the help of litmus paper. Otherwise, normal indicators will respond to both these acids in a similar way. Both these acids will turn the color of blue litmus into red color. But if you want to know which one is strong, otherwise which acid is weak, we can use another indicator which is actually known as a universal indicator. You have this term, can you underline this term? Universal indicator. What are normal indicators? The examples that we have in the first page of the chapter, like what? Litmus paper. You can use turmeric, methyl orange, phenolphthalein, all these are normal indicators. Their only purpose is to show whether the given liquid is acidic or basic in nature. They will not help you to identify whether the acid is strong, otherwise whether it's weak. Same with bases. Bases also, last day we discussed, there are strong bases and there are weak bases. Normal indicators will not serve the purpose of identifying whether the acid or base is strong or weak. But which one can be used to identify whether acid or base is strong or weak? We can use a universal indicator. And it's available in form of solution. We call it as a pH solution, a universal indicator solution. Otherwise, it's available in the form of small paper strips, pH paper strips. Using either of these, it's possible for us to identify that a universal indicator is a solution which helps us to identify whether the given solution is a strong acid, whether it's a weak acid, whether it's a strong base or whether it's a weak base. How? It shows, just like normal indicators, it shows different colors in presence of strong and weak acids, otherwise in presence of strong and weak bases. Can you all refer to the next page? You have a color chart, figure 2.7. If you use universal indicator and dip it in acidic and basic solutions, universal indicator, otherwise pH paper, will be giving these possible colors. You can see the colors in the color chart. It's only a rough guide. The colors range from red, from the left hand side, I'm just mentioning the colors. It can be red, it can be orange, it can be yellow, it can be a shade of green. I think the screen is clear, otherwise it's very clear in your textbook. It can be a shade of blue and it can be indigo color. In the extreme right hand, you can see it is indigo color. So all these different colors can be shown by universal indicator, that is pH paper. Depending on what? Depending on the amount of H plus ions present in the given solution. Universal indicator will turn its color to either of these colors. Depending upon what? The amount of H plus ion present in the given solution that you are testing. Suppose you test for a neutral solution. Neutral solution, the pH value of it is 7. You know what is a neutral solution, right? A solution which neither shows an acidic nature or a basic nature. We call it as a neutral solution. The pH value of a neutral solution, what is values, we'll discuss later. Right now, listen to this. The value of pure water is 7, is indicated here. If you dip a pH paper strip in pure water, this will be the color, a light shade of green. So it's very clear, that is, by looking at the color to which the pH paper has changed its color to, you can identify whether it's neutral. Suppose it's turned its color to red, the pH value may be 0. And such solutions are having an acidic nature. The color range that you see from here up to the value of 7. These values, otherwise these colors, are usually given by what type of solutions? Acidic solutions. So what are the pH values possible for an acidic solution? The solutions will have pH value ranging from 0 up to 7. 7 is not a value for acidic solution. 7 stands for a neutral solution. Now values from 7, that is not 7, 7 and above up to 14. They are values for basic solutions. So basic solutions differ in the number of which ions? OH minus ions. So based on the quantity of H plus ions and OH minus ions, the solutions will give different colors with pH paper. And it's easy for you to check whether the given solution is acidic or basic by referring to the color chart. You know, pH is actually can you copy down this equation? The equation is not there in your textbook. Copy this down, I'll be asking this. pH is equal to minus log, log is a mathematical operator, to the base 10 of H plus ion concentration. To make it simple, you know, 2 raised to 3 is 8. So we say logarithm of 8 is the value to which 2 is raised to. So log of 8 is 3. Otherwise, if you take 1000, 1000 is 10 raised to 3, right? So log value of 1000 is 3. You don't have to learn in details. You just need to learn this formula. pH is log to the base 10 of H plus ion concentration. So you know, H plus ion concentration differs. For strong acids, it will be much higher. For weak acid, the H plus ion ions will be very less. So depending upon the H plus ion produced by acids, their pH value can vary. pH value usually has a range. The values can be 0 and it can be as high as 14. This is pH range. Looking at this pH range, otherwise pH value, is possible for us to identify whether the given solution is acidic or basic in nature. Can you all refer to this picture, figure 2.6. It's a scale in which all these values are noted. Can you note the values? It's from 0, at the center portion of it, you can see the value 7. And at the extreme right end, you can see the value 14. For any basic or acidic solution, the values will be within this range. That is what range? The value can vary only from 0 up to 14. Look at the value written in the center. The value is 7, right? The middle point of it is a value which usually a neutral solution has. You know, neutral solutions don't show any acidic or basic nature. Now, the reason is clear. Actually, the shading part is not complete here in the diagram. The blue color has to extend actually up to this dotted lines. It's a mistake in your textbook. The blue coloring has to extend up to this dotted lines. Okay, suppose you, that is for neutral solution, suppose you see in the diagram that the blue color extends up to the dotted lines. Can you refer to the middle portion of it and check why a neutral solution don't show any acidic or basic nature? See, the blue color labeling is something which actually marks the amount of H plus ion. The amount of H plus ion is actually denoted by the blue color shading. And amount of OH minus ion is actually denoted by the portion which is not shaded with blue. So why a solution is neutral? Why solution with pH value 7 is neutral? It's clear from the diagram. Such solutions have same number of H plus ion. If the blue color extends up to this dotted line, it has same number of H plus ion and OH minus ion. So that's why the solution is neutral in nature. Now go for the extreme left end. The pH value mentioned there is 0. To remember an important point, 0 is a value which actually denotes the strongest acid. So extreme left end, the solution with pH value 0 represent what type of acid? A strongest acid, the most strong acid. The reason is clear. Can you refer to the blue color area and the area which is not shaded in blue? Such solution has the highest concentration of H plus ion. Is that clear? Such solution has the highest concentration of H plus ion. Moving to the right. Suppose I go for the case here, the solution with pH value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is happening to the concentration of H plus ion? Concentration of H plus ion is keeping on decreasing. So all these solutions with all these pH values, that is pH value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, you know, all are acids. But the strength is not the same. Why? You know, strength of an acid is decided by the amount of H plus ion produced by it. And among these acids, which acid is having more of H plus ion? The one with pH value 0. as the pH value is increasing, actually the acid strength is keeping on decreasing. And when the value became 7, the solution is now neutral in nature. So why the acidic strength is not same for these liquids? Liquids with pH value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. The amount of H plus ion is not the same for these acids. So how can you generalize? The acid with the least value of pH will be the acid which produce more number of H plus ion, and hence it will be stronger compared to the other acids. We'll discuss it in detail later. Now we'll move on to the other side. Here, values will be like what? 9, 10, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. This area is actually area of bases. Values above 7 up to 14 is area of bases. Bases actually are characterized by which ions? OH minus ion. So, the base which has more number of OH minus ion is actually a strong base. Comparing these solutions, the one with pH value 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. Can you refer to the picture and tell the answer for this question? Which solution has more of OH minus ion? Comparing all these solutions, definitely the one which is having pH value 14. You can see that solution has very less number of H plus ion. But it has more of which ions? OH minus ion. Otherwise, if you compare a solution having pH value 8 and pH value 12, which one is stronger base? Definitely the one with pH value 12. Why? It has more number of OH minus ion compared to the solution having pH value 8. So how do you compare the strength of acids? Strength of acids depend upon the number of H plus ions produced by it when it ionizes, when it is dissolved in water. Acids which produce more of H plus ions are comparatively stronger compared to the other acids. Here in these examples, the acid with pH value 0 is considered to be strongest. Why? It produces more of H plus ion compared to rest of the acids. Now coming to the side of bases. Basic strength is determined by the amount of OH minus ion produced on ionization. If you compare bases of different pH values, that is pH value above 7 up to 14, which solution has more of basic strength? The one which produces more of OH minus ion. So here on right hand side, which solution has more of OH minus ion comparing the rest of the solutions? The one with pH value 14. So hence it is the strongest base. So strongest acids, that is the strongest ones, have pH value 0. Strongest bases have pH value 14. Now you'll think whether here in the side of bases, that is pH value 14, you can see that along with OH minus ions, it's having which ions also? H plus ions also, right? So the question is, will a base have H plus ions in it? A base is something which ionizes and produces what? OH minus ion. But here in this diagram is shown that even the strongest base is having H plus ion. What's the reason for that? How do bases start ionizing? Bases start ionizing when they are dissolved in what? Water. So water, you know, in presence of bases, ionizes and produces what? This is what water will do. In presence of bases, water ionizes to H plus ions and OH minus ion. Suppose you're adding sodium hydroxide to this water. It also ionizes, right? Ionizes to Na plus ions and OH minus ion. So comparing the two ions, which ions will be having more concentration? H plus or OH minus ion for a basic solution? For a basic solution, definitely OH minus ions will be more in number. Similarly, if you take the case of acids, if you take the example of hydrochloric acid ionizes and produces what? H plus ion and Cl minus ion. And this ionization takes place in presence of what? Water. Water, when you add acid to it, water ionizes to what? H plus ion and OH minus ion. So acidic solutions also have, along with H plus ion, here you could see acidic solutions have what ions also? OH minus ions. But which ion is more in number? definitely H plus ion is more in number compared to OH minus ion. That's why acids show acidic nature. Now, why bases show basic nature? In the case of bases, OH minus ion will be more in number compared to H plus ion. Now, coming to the center portion of this, it's now clear why a neutral solution do not show any acidic or basic nature. Why? In the case of neutral solutions, H plus ions and OH minus ion will be same in number. We'll discuss this later. We'll start with the interactive session. Is Glenn there? Can you all turn your audio and video on? Students, can you turn your audio and video on?